How you doing? Dave here. We are on our way over to the Freedom House City Center downtown Brantford to set up our 24/7 prayer room. And I thought I'd bring you along and tell you a little about our week of 24/7 prayer coming up in the process. Let's go. Our first stop of the tour is actually the old Big Blue House. If you'll remember, this is where we used to have the prayer room. You'd come into the store, knock on the middle of the night, and there'd be candles going and music happening in this room. So what we're doing is we're actually taking pieces of the old room and we're putting it in the new room. Little pieces of memory of 24/7 prayer weeks gone by, and we're bringing it into the new city center for the new prayer room. So that'll be kind of neat. So when you're looking for the Freedom House City Center to where to come for the 24/7 prayer week, it's easy. You head downtown and you look for what used to be the Eden's Market Square. We're right downtown there. So what you do is you head inside, you go right down the elevator, and right around to the left is where you find a room where people are going to be praying around the clock, 24/7. Isn't that amazing? If you remember, the reason why 24/7 prayer started, it was actually inspired by a guy named Count Zinzendorf. In fact, it was inspired by the people that showed up at Count Zinzendorf's house. They showed up at his place, this gigantic palatial estate, and they just started praying. They started praying and praying and praying. They prayed for 125 years, and what happened out of this 125-year prayer meeting was that missionaries were launched all over the world. There were people sent to Africa. There were people sent all over Europe. Communities were changed because of prayer. Mission and justice were birthed out of prayer. That's why we pray. That's why we're about to pray in this room right here for an entire week. Right, Andrea?
Oh, yes.
One of the cool things about what we're going to do at the 24/7 prayer week this time is we're going to be having a coffee house as well, so you can come down and hang out here. We're going to have all kinds of coffee and snacks and that kind of thing. But what we're going to do is we're going to be praying around the clock for the city of Brantford, and this is our prayer room, okay? So if you've never been a part of the 24/7 prayer week before, what we do is we block off an entire week into 1 hour segments. Now, if you would like to, if you'd have a link to the sign-up sheet, we have it all online. If you don't have it yet, you can email me, dave@freedomhouse.ca, and I'll send it to you. But what we need to have happen is people to sign up for every single hour in an entire week. Every single hour in an entire week, there'll be somebody in this room right here praying. There's all sorts of different things that you can do in the prayer room. This board right here, the big board, is going to be up, and you can tack your prayer requests on there. In fact, we even encourage you to get prayer requests from friends and family members. And the blackboard is also going to be up here. We're going to be able to you're going to be able to write things that God's saying down. You'll be able to come in here, over in this corner here, there'll be a computer, and we'll be able to kind of blog along on www.freedomhousebrantford.blogspot.com, what's going on in the prayer room, what God's saying to people, all that kind of stuff. It's really quite an interesting process. If you've never been a part of it, come down to the city center next week. Sign up for an hour of prayer and be a part of something that is absolutely life-changing, because the thing is when you invite God in to a place and you keep on talking to him and you don't let go of him, he doesn't let go of you, and he just fills a room like you've never experienced before. It's a week of 24/7 prayer in Brantford next week. Go sign up for your hours today. I'm looking forward to it.